So today I am painting Bayside at about 123rd Street, right next to a nice pier and park. This is the scene. I'm gonna paint that long pier and some of the houses in the distance and the water, a little bit of the marshland. I'm set up on a 9x12, one of my panels that I make that is gator board and canvas. And my palette is the same split palette that I always use, which is titanium white, cad yellow medium, lemon yellow, cad red medium. I think this is quinacridone magenta, ultramarine blue, cerulean, and I have some colors left over from my last painting, which is burnt sienna black, yellow ochre, and some chrome green that I like to use just as a base green, and then I mix my other greens. Today I am going to tone my canvas, so I might wind up moving it into the shade a little bit, but I like to tone my canvas because then if any white shows or any non-painted canvas shows through, then it's not just white. And I don't want it super wet. I just want it not white. Today, instead of pencil, I'm actually going to use a brush. So I started with the large bristle brush. I started with a number 6 hog bristle flat. It's a Treco long. I kind of like these to mop things in. But pretty quickly I go to something a little bit smaller. This is a cheapo bristle brush. This is an 8. Okay, now I'm mixing a color for the water. I'm gonna do some ultramarine, a little bit of cerulean, and some white. Might add some cad red medium into it. See how that looks? Yeah, it's pretty close. I'm just getting a base color in there. I'll come back in and add some highlights. Distant shoreline. I should take a shot of this before it changes too much. I like to kind of put it on thinly. I think the washes look kind of cool. But there we go. The bristle brush is really good for scrubbing in. Get it in all the weave of the canvas. Just a little firmer. The water tends to get lighter as it gets closer. So I'm going to add some white in down here. So now I'm gonna do some darker stuff in the distance. Okay. Now I'm going to get some sky in there. This is more cerulean. A lot of white. It's a pretty pale sky today, so I'm going to go a lot more white. I can get even lighter than that. Nice peaceful day here on the bayside. September 4th, 2023. Here's where the houses start. I'm just gonna generally get around the houses. There's some trees over there too, which is gonna add a nice touch. Alright, now I'm going to get some more white in down near the bottom. Kind of like the water, it's dark down to light, but here it's darker down to lighter, so I'm going to make this a little lighter. Even lighter still. Clean my brush off. I think that water is too red. I'm gonna come in and kind of dull that out a little bit. So, quickest way to dull out a color is to use the opposite color. So for the red, for the blue, it would be the orange color. So I'm gonna dull that out a little bit. And now it's too red, so I'm gonna add some green in. Too green. The thing I like about oil painting is that you definitely can come back in and fix stuff. I'm going to get a little lighter in here. Definitely like it less red, so that is good. Alright, and I can come back in and add some ripples and stuff in there, but this is a good start. Okay. Alright, now I'm going to switch to a synthetic flat. I like these Princeton Aspen brushes. This is a number 4. And I'm going to start putting in some of the houses, just to give me some foundation of what I'm looking at. So there's gonna be a dark line here, and I'm just gonna kind of warm up my white and put some houses in here. I'll add definition to them as I go. we're gonna make, there's one with kind of a brownish roof. Gonna pink that up a little bit. Gray. One thing I've found over the years painting this kind of stuff is you don't need to go crazy with detail and stuff in the distance because you want it to fade away. And if you get too bogged down in details, you wind up bringing too much focus on it. And some windows, just imply some windows. Someone coming up behind me. Nope, trash truck. Okay, painting the marsh grass now. Don't want to get too crazy with details. Just add some strokes in there. You need to start with the darks and then come back over top with the lights. But I want to keep it kind of fresh and spontaneous. There we go. Lighten it up even more. Use some lemon yellow and some white on these tops. Kind of bring some attention over here. Alright, now I need some highlights on that dock. So I have some yellow in my brush. I'm going to add some white to it. Kind of brown it down a little bit. Same thing over here. And a couple of highlights, like a chimney or something. Off in the distance, on the other side of the shore, there's a building. It's going to imply some stuff over there. It's also a very faint shoreline, so I'm going to get that in some brown. Mixing kind of a weird little green blue in here. Try and get some marshy colors. So all kinds of reflections going on. I think that's the fun stuff. Need some white. Now for some people. Let's start with some figures. fishing. People. Now I'm going smaller with a number two flat. Going to take some of these colors and add a little bit here. Maybe a little dark color for someone's legs. This is pretty loose. I usually don't paint this loose, but I'm trying to keep it loose. I kind of like trying different stuff when I paint. One thing I noticed is that in the seagrass there's some red, some orange in there. It's kind of nice. Just gonna add that in. Add a little variation in here. Way off in the distance, I see a little bit of red on that roof. I'm gonna put that in there. There we go. Now coming in with some details. probably would call this a sketch more than a finished like painting, but I think you gotta do hundreds of paintings before you feel really comfortable with your finished product. And I think the more you do, the better you get. Okay. Getting there. Just about done. I need some more darks. I'm gonna do some browns with my greens and get some of this in. Get even darker there. It's in there. Now I think the houses in the background are a little too random. I'm gonna fix those up a little bit. Bit of yellow, maybe. I got the TV. There we go. A little bit more order. I kind of dig. Stuff's not perfect, but it's not too random. There we go. flattening my brush out real thin. Get some thin stuff from my flat. A couple of this marsh grass. Okay, I'm stepping back and just taking a look. I'm thinking a little bit of blue in the background, a little faded green blue in the background up in here. Need to fade it some more. I'm about ready for my second cup of coffee. If you're in Ocean City, Maryland, try Rise Up Coffee. I've been getting it every morning and it's been awesome. My drink is the Americano. There we go. It's nice and faded. What else do I need? A little bit darker roof. I'm using a leftover palette, so I'm trying to use up all the colors. This is from my last painting. I think we're done. I might just knock out some of that sharp edge there and call it a day. A little yellow green in here. Soften it up. Maybe a little bit of highlight here. A little life on those docks. Can't really tell from here if they have boats on there or not. I can't imagine they wouldn't. So that's the finished painting. That is the scene. So that's the last painting for today. I think it's time for a coffee, but this one was fun. I learned a lot from this, and I look forward to the next one. Please like, subscribe, and watch as many paintings as you can. I'm gonna try and keep figuring out this format, and I appreciate your checking it out.